I'm gonna join Redcoats here. Guys, we just need one guy over on the White Fox side to get those tickets.
Oh. Yep, I'm here.
Okay. Armcut, you'll be over there. Matt, you gonna be on Redcoats?
Yep, I'll jump on shortly. I'm just.
Okay. I got 45 seconds here until match start.
Confirm we're on Badlands.
Nope, we are on Candyland.
Seven seconds.
Go, go, go.
Go, go.
All right, following the red coats there. I love how they spawn in their whole team and they just rush out of main, ready to go. All right, it's following the redcoats here. Bring up our roster there. You can see we are on Russian Army here.
Something very interesting from White Fox's game. They're playing with a single squad with a single squad leader in it. So it's going to be interesting to see what they do with that.
Interesting. You know, I think they did that last round. I'm not entirely sure.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's do this. Let's do this.
White Fox
right off the break here, White Fox taking a couple guys that north western
Russ,
side of the map.
Go.
See if they can get a cheeky flank off on the redcoats here.
You have them coming off that hill towards third.
How far, Jeps?
Yeah, redcoats have picked up on their movement coming down that hill. My 195 here.
Oh, yeah, they're being engaged right now. That's one of the dangers of coming down off that hill is that you get spotted, and especially going against the Russian team, which has optics advantage. It's very dangerous to do that. So White Fox got off pretty lucky here, coming down that hill without taking too many casualties or even any casualties at all.
Rush, do you want me to go to the third flag? You bang into it. Russ, are you banging to third or should I?
Big grenade there. Russ and Bats go down.
Are you banging to third or am I?
The redcoats once again pushing strong on the middle. They have a good amount of forces right here in their second cap. They know how important that middle strength is. They have very few guys up on that western hill.
Very intense grenade.
As of now.
Yeah, absolutely. Very intense grenade fire here. Almost entire Redcoat squad.
It's going to be very interesting to see if Redcoats decide to continue pushing on that northwestern side up the hill, or if they decide to rush it to the third flag. It appears right now that they're going to try to take control of this western hill.
Yeah, Japsy, watch out up there. Snackle seems to think they've got a fob up on that hill there, somewhere to your south-southeast.
Yeah, now, does White Fox have a fob up on the hill there? The Redcoats are calling that out on Commander Comms, saying that they think they see a fob up there.
There is a fob on the western hill tucked in behind the bridges here.
Yeah, it looks like the Redcoats have already spotted that. And they're relaying that information. Japsy is relaying that information down to the guys on the ground. Over in the middle there, and Japsy, his squad moving up already on this fob. This could be a very early fob neutralization here for Redcoats.
Negative for the minute, mate. My guys.
Luckily, though, White Fox has managed to put down a second FOB behind their second cap, so they will have a backup reinforcement area. Very interesting to see that White Fox actually decided to build a couple fortifications on this western FOB. You usually don't see that in competitive games. FOBs are usually mainly used for their spawning capabilities, not their defensive capabilities. And it's really interesting to see that White Fox attempted to build a FOB on that western hill. Once again, you can see White Fox a little weak in the middle. Redcoats do have the numbers advantage in the on that third cap. White Fox is again playing the sides as heavy as they were that first round. So we'll see if that they're able to do the same flanks and catch Redcoats off guard again.
I think they've taken it down.
Copy.
Yeah, so Redcoats now only two men up now on the hills to the west, western hills here, skirmishing with White Fox up on the top here. And Redcoats do have a FOB down there over in Echo 6, keypad 4.
Nice!
Right behind that last defense flag that they have. I'm floating back over the middle here, looking at this Redcoats advance here.
Yeah, not a lot of aggression in the middle from White Fox. Both teams are mainly staying on their sides of the river. A lot of the fighting going on those side hills right now.
Absolutely.
My guy's down just to your south for us if you can clear it.
Once again, you see Redcoats utilizing that gully. They know just how important that gully is, and that if they can control it, they can control most of the river and that defensive cap.
We've got a squad. Maybe putting a fob up there somewhere.
Thank you.
Very slow game right now.
Absolutely, yeah. 141 tickets here for the Reds.
130 for White Fox.
130 there for White Fox, alright.
How's it going, Russ? How's it going?
They did lose that fob off to the west here, and Redcoats are continuing their push on that western hill. White Fox is looking in their direction, but we'll see if Redcoats manage to use the terrain to their advantage and conceal themselves.
Enemy, then we see a west, Russ.
We're going to push onto that attack flag.
Roger that, Jack.
I like how the Redcoats are using these eastern buildings on the third cap to kind of control that area looking down westward. They're able to shut off a lot of the south there, and you can see White Fox kind of realizes that, and they're kind of shifting around to the northwestern side to avoid those buildings completely.
Yeah, Russ, I hear him, mate. I'm kind of towards
now. I really wonder where those four guys are actually going to move to now after from that building's area of control, whether they're going to try and go around it to the north and go behind Redcoats, or whether they're just going to try and charge straight through.
White Fox in a really good position right now, enveloping that gully. They're going to be able to control that gully and possibly even attempt to cap this flag. Redcoats are committing a five-man squad after that western hill, but they're moving really slowly, so that's kind of a long-term investment that Redcoats made, and we'll see if they're able to, you know, get behind them just like how White Fox did to them on that first round and disrupt them enough to attack that third flag. White Fox now pushing into that gully, controlling it.
Hey, we're getting hit hard. They're overrunning us on this D flag.
Drop it.
See a couple White Fox, both three-man White Fox fire team off to the far east here, skirmishing with
Russ, are we
very
the
few redcoat
not
horses.
Yet, but
that might be a
seconds, mate. We're getting overrun,
bad allocation
no
of resources right now. There's almost no one over there except for one redcoat player. They brought the... Oh, you can see right now, actually, Redcoats making a huge push on the southern side of the attack flag, catching a whole White Fox squad out in the open. They're going to be able to do a lot of damage here as White Fox was caught looking north, and this Redcoat squad was able to push in on the south side.
New fob marked.
Copy. Nice, Jeps. Get it.
you right now. Redcoats. Oh, go ahead.
Absolutely. Redcoats really working it now. You can see there on my screen. Japsai squad coming down into this village here. And doing basically the same thing that we saw from White Fox last round. Coming down in here and disrupting this this flow of reinforcements that White Fox has coming out of this this location on the map. Most of those guys are down now. Still a couple of Redcoats guys up in the hills there. But most of the fighting now contained down to the center of the valley.
The White Fox playing those eastern hills really heavily. Redcoats able to exploit that and push their main force onto the cap now. And I do believe they are protecting that flag from being capped.
What do you think that plan is in the Far East? Where do you think they're actually going to do with that? The two guys that are just absolutely off in the distance.
Well, by the looks of it, they had just put down a farm on the east over here. So I believe they're just kind of screening for that FOB to make sure Redcoats don't find it and can't catch a free fob again, considering how they lost a free fob on the west. The thing about this, though, is they're sending guys to protect the fob, not necessarily attack an objective. And that's kind of drawing these forces away from the main fight, and so it's allowing Redcoats to push onto the objective. So I think White Fox right now is stuck protecting this FOB that they put down.
We're getting wiped on the D. We're getting wiped on the D.
Roger. I'm just getting RP down there.
East up the hill from the D around the compound.
Yeah, you can see the difference in how both teams play the hills. You can see how Redcoats right now playing the hills, but they're playing them aggressively. Not necessarily sitting on the hills and trying to pick off a few kills at long range, but they're trying to get down and right up next to WF so that they can disrupt WF's plans and reinforcements moving into attack.
Right.
Whereas you see White Fox's squad on the east just sitting out there just not really doing much, not really impacting the game as much as they could be.
So there you could hear Rusk K there on Commander Com saying they're capping it fast. Guys inside the objective was calling enemies coming down from the hills of the east, but now you can see that southern part of the cap there, White Fox in control, sitting along that wall there. So a lot of guerrilla tactics push from the hills in the east. Which, you know, Redcoats start pointing their guns that way, and then we get this squad here for White Fox pushing into the cap on the south side.
They're all over it, mate, in the fields. Watch the
now, it'll be really interesting to see. Oh, never mind. I was going to say, Japsai could have a play here coming in behind White Fox's squad on the south, but he just got picked off with a really nice grenade.
Enemy sniper to the south.
Seems pretty even on this contested flag right here.
Thank you.
Both teams taking a lot of casualties trying to get bodies on top of it.
Jeff, you can put some pressure on that attack flag.
Right now you can see the problem with holding those western hills. Redcoats trying to come down off those western hills to assist the main flag, but they're getting picked off as they're running down in the open off those hills.
Enemies are coming northeast. Hold on.
122 tickets here for the Redcoats. How's White Fox looking?
111 tickets for White Fox, but they have managed to neutralize this northern flag.
Good to go. Watch out for the backlist.
Roger that, en route.
Watch out for the fields and northeast.
6-0.
Again, Redcoats just setting up that line in the gully.
That field, boys. They cannot withstand it. Nade them.
White Fox using that western hill, or that western wall. Sorry, go ahead.
Seems that most of those guys in the gully are actually down, though. Everybody's in when we can. Only two or three left up, it seems.
You can see how they used it to push across, though. You can see Deffy right now sneaking up, and he actually, I think, caught Nathan and...
Yeah, he just can't.
Mostly.
He's doing pretty well. He's creeping along with his RPG, just pulling it out and shooting when he sees guys.
See if Deffy is able to set up river control on that side. Slow down WF from moving in across that river. We do see WF starting to utilize their eastern fob a lot more right now.
That's Rossi Raider on comms there saying Redcoats are capping back fast. But they've got the bodies in the cap. White Fox now moving in. A couple of guys here coming through the river now. Been hearing intermittent comms directed towards Japs Eye. They're relying a lot on that squad over there.
Yeah. Yes.
His squad to disrupt as much as they can this White Fox reinforcement. And looks like Japs has kind of shifted his squad off of that compound and more towards the northern fields. And they're kind of hanging behind these walls here, shooting at these White Fox guys that are crossing the river.
White Fox making a really large push onto this cap right now. They're actually starting to contest on those eastern hills as well, not just sitting up there, but actively pushing into the redcoats and interrupting their reinforcements. And this is actually relieving a lot of pressure from their attacking team, and they might be able to finish capping this flag. Sitting at about 104 tickets right now for the White Fox.
113 here for the Reds.
Pretty close game.
Rest anybody's in the cap when you can.
As we can see, going to the scoreboard, once again, both teams very even in gunplay. It's going to come down to the objectives. Basically, just tied on kills.
Absolutely, 39-39.
Starting to re-neutralize it off him.
Copy that.
Again, if you're just joining us, White Fox did lose the first round to the Redcoats, but they lost by a mere 30 tickets, which in terms of disabling objectives and fobs is not that much. So this could get very tight if White Fox is able to beat these Reds out in a little bit of gunplay as well as take some of these objectives.
So we can get a quick cap on this so you can do your business, mate. Nice.
Roger that.
Jeff, he's still up here on this western wall.
Seems that we've got a redcoat squad in the next capture point towards further to the south. Almost in anticipation of if they can contest that flag that White Fox is actually currently in now. If they can take that, they've already got the squad over there.
Right.
It just seems to be lying in wait.
Yeah, and
it does seem like, yeah.
We saw that from Redcoats as well last round. They like to really roll through these objectives. So if they can take an objective, the Redcoats seem to, more often than not, they look at an objective and say, well, we can definitely take this first one, but what if we can take both of them almost at the same time? And we're seeing that right now. Redcoats there, you can hear on comms a little bit of chatter that they're taking back that flag right now. So we'll see if they can get this double cap here. That would certainly be a big blow for White Fox.
Looks like the Russians have recaptured that flag, and they are going to start decapping that third cap. Redcoats in a really strong position here because they sent this preemptive squad over here to just kind of lay the groundwork and kind of set up security before they can shift more forces over to assist.
Understood. Send a few guys over.
White Fox doing the best they can right now to kind of weed out these Redcoats players that are sitting in the fields over here.
Now I have enemy on the hill on the mark, the sniper mark.
These Redcoats players in the fields are doing a lot of damage right here. White Fox is having a really hard time trying to find and weed out every single player here.
Yeah, Rainbow Blues just had a really good run on a couple of guys that are in that gully now, though. And that seems to really hurt their air. Ooh, and Rainbow Blue's just been shot by Hickman, who was one of the guys in the field.
Keep it going, keep it going.
We're 30%.
Really something interesting right here is Redcoats have a rally point right on that attack flag. It's within about, I don't know, 20 meters of one of the White Fox players, and you saw them all just spawn in right there, and that's going to offer instant reinforcement for these forces capping this flag. It's going to be pretty crucial if Redcoats can keep those players alive and keep clearing out White Fox. Team spawning in right on top of the cap zone.
Russ, I'm going to start sending some of my guys that are alive south.
See almost the entire Redcoats team on the other side of the map inside the gully right here.
They're now capping it back. Copy.
White Fox still controlling those eastern hills, shutting down any hopes of Redcoats using those that side of the map to get a flank.
Roger that.
Redcoats using that gully to try to use it for cover as they maneuver across the river here.
Yeah. 100 tickets now for Redcoats.
81 for White Fox.
Yeah, send all you guys, Russ. Send all you guys.
Redcoats have a really big chance here to take this flag. A lot of White Fox's forces are either down or on that eastern side of the map, spawning in on that fob that's very far away. They need to start spawning on the main if they want to get back to this cap fast enough. As you can see, one of White Fox's squads did do that. They're coming down the hill right now. Now, once again, that issue with coming down off the hill, either from main or from a FOB, is that you are showing yourself considerably. You have zero cover coming down that hill for about the good 30 seconds, 10 seconds it takes to get down that hill. Right now, they're being GP'd and everything.
Yep. Oh, man.
Didn't even look like Redcoats needed that rally point, though. They've just stormed straight across that river now. Quick.
Redcoats making a huge aggressive play right here, and you see a lot of White Fox forces on the eastern side of the map scrambling to get back to this cap. They're going to need help trying to retake this flag.
And as you said earlier, there's three guys down on that hill.
Dangerous. Very dangerous coming down that hill. Good play by Redcoats, leaving a couple guys on the opposite side of the river. Now they're going to be able to stop and slow down this White Fox reinforcing squad from the FOB on the east and prevent them from crossing the river to help on the defensive flag.
Copy that, Russ.
Redcoats doing a great job of shutting down all reinforcements, both from the east and the western hills.
Russ. Yeah, those two guys are completely blown to that attack on the east now, with a couple of good shoots.
Yeah, our rally's down. We're going to have to come in off the fob.
You can see White Fox and Redcoats running right past each other in the fields. Those fields offer such dense protection, or not protection, but concealment, that one of the only ways you can really effectively weed out players in the fields is either with elevation and optics, which they can't do because that hill has little to no cover, or explosives like grenades or RPGs. And I just am not seeing White Fox utilize their explosives as much as I'd like to.
Marcus, coming to your north, chaps. Watch out.
99 tickets.
There is a large amount of luck.
43 tickets for White Fox here.
Go ahead, Matt.
There's a large amount of luck with the explosives, though. You know, you could throw 10 grenades and just completely have poor luck and miss the guy.
That's true. Yeah, you do have to know where they are. That's the difficulty of these fields.
How's it looking, Japs?
Oh, good, man. Safe, secure, Japs, move forward.
White Fox actually did a very good job pushing Redcoats off. There are only a couple left in this cap. And you can see White Fox now enveloping that cap. And they will have the angles to kind of weed out these last two Redcoats players inside the cap. You can see they're also setting up a very nice river control kind of pair of people here next to the third flag. They will be able to lock down this river and kind of stop Redcoats reinforcements from crossing that river safely.
Oh,
Redcoats realize this and they decide to cross the river further north behind the bend, cutting off the line of sight from that this player's on the river right there. The White Fox.
My rally. I'm spawning at my rally, and we're going to move. We're going to move on them hills.
Tell Dipsauce in your squad there's an RP to his east.
Game's kind of slowing down here as both teams aim to regroup themselves and get another line set up. You can see Redcoats right now spawning back at that FOB, trying to kind of settle the game and stabilize the game to a point where they can make another play. They are keeping the pressure up, which is very nice to see.
Yeah, Russ, if you can, might push some bodies in there just to get on it.
You can see the majority of the fighting.
Go, Japs. There's multiple contacts on this road near the D.
34 tickets for White Fox.
All right, 90 here for Redcoats.
Yeah, still looking at the scoreboard. Barry almost even in kills, just a 10 kill difference. It's amazing how much bleed really affects the games and how much pressure that bleed applies to a team.
Russ, enemies to your north, enemies to your north.
Smokes up, smokes up.
Seems that the Redco advance on the western side, most seems to stall, but they're all in. Seems that most of them are actually down. Are you seeing any medic action?
I think there's only one player up near all those downed Redcoats, and you can see White Fox pushing in to kind of finish the job and keep those medics from reviving people. Very good aggression by White Fox to prevent revives by the medics.
If you need me to, I can get a fob up here, boys.
They're neutralized, they're neutralized. We need to push in, we need to push in. Do you want to risk it? Do you want to risk it? I mean, they've got guys on that hill, it could be straight away in rain.
Yeah, I wouldn't risk it, mate. There's enemies on here.
Seems as well now White Fox consolidating on that, capture point just to make sure they've got it completely locked down.
They are using that gully as well. See, that gullies offer pretty much the most solid cover on this map.
Redcoat's talking on commander comms now about pushing bodies into that cap, and they're getting reports from these guys up on the hill saying, yeah, we see a lot of guys crawling down there.
If they follow cap,
I don't think they're going to push into this cap. Looks like Redcoats are going to stay out.
Give this flag one push. If not, then we'll just go into TDM on the next flag.
Now it's Rusty K saying, let's give this flag one push. So we'll see what they end up doing here.
This could get really interesting now. We've got White Fox pushing straight into that next capture point, and there's no Redcoats there defending.
Yeah, White Fox making an aggressive push, and I'm pretty sure they had some sort of feeling that there was little defensive force over here, seeing as they're sprinting through the fields. It's a really good call out by the White Fox squad leaders to kind of make this push and kind of do what they can to bring this game back.
Right.
Enemies to my east, guys, are moving into the D now.
Well, now we got Rossi saying he sees lots of enemies moving into the defensive cap now. So we'll see if they can. Redcoats can surround these guys and neutralize them. Redcoats do have the advantage on these guys' flank. Looks like a little bit of a pocket is now developing with Russ UK there to my north, and Rossi squad
enemies
there to the
markers,
west.
Wait. Enemies on their markers, southeast. What's that flag looking like, big man?
60%. They've got it on 60%.
Copy.
60% now for White Fox on that cap.
They're going for a quick push.
Redcoat's getting a little disorganized and starting to get it's a little touchy here.
We need bodies in here now. We need bodies in here now.
We're moving. We're moving.
Down at the moment.
Low wall in the middle. No wall.
White Fox getting caught in the field here. That nade takes out at least three White Fox players. Yeah, you can see Redcoats really utilizing their explosives effectively, weeding out White Fox players there in the field here. Yeah, those grenades are on point.
Yeah, very accurate grenades.
And they've just decimated that White Fox assault now.
How are your guys' tickets looking after that push?
28 tickets for, 26 tickets for White Fox after that push.
Yeah, I'm just a little under double that there, 50 tickets now for Redcoats.
I think the one thing that we really are getting down to now in these final stages of the tournament is that the teams really are all excellent. You know, I can remember watching White Fox last week and the Redcoats where, you know, there was a bit more of a gap with White Fox, but now they really are meeting people that are, you know, really, really on point and giving them a really good run for their money.
Guys, they've got a fob up in them northeastern hills. I just cannot see where it is. It's probably far, far, you know? It's not even worth a push to that fob for the minute, boys. Just consolidate.
Aye, that's it, mate. Sit in, dig in, do business, mate.
Russ UK there, announcing to his team, sit in, dig in. Redcoats
now.
Yeah,
once again.
Yeah, looking for that defensive hold right now.
Blowing the game as the tickets get lower and lower.
East of the D, east of the D, on the hill.
Roger that.
They're trying to flank round, they're trying to flank round.
Roger that, mate. What's the cap looking like? We've got guys in the cap.
I'm on the cap myself, 100%, 100%.
Copy. Chaps, if you can even neutralise that again, mate, that'd be a great push.
Yeah, we're on it, mate.
Roger that. Do your thing, brother, do your thing.
Here, we're getting surrounded on the D here. What's happening? We're not consolidating on this, chaps.
You're
attacking that now.
No, let chaps push. Yeah, let him neutralise that flag. Give us some breathing room.
White Fox trying to make a push on that northeastern side of the gully and try to catch a lot of the redcoats in the open in the gully. They might be able to get a couple more tickets over here. 16 tickets left for White Fox. Redcoats pushing back, just weeding out who they can, trying to get trying to close out the game.
We're having a squad wipe.
A couple of White Fox players inside the cap, prone. There's only two players there, so they are not able to neutralize that.
You see this rock down the freaking gully right here? The big old one on the left?
Yes. Keep it up, guys. Keep it up.
There's a guy behind you.
Keep it up. Nice, chaps.
That's on that jab.
Half cut, mate.
Nice.
D is fine. D is fine.
Yes.
46 tickets here for the Reds.
11 left for White Fox.
Well done, Japs. Well done.
We got this.
Yeah, baby. Well
you
done,
actually
well
see Redcoats going to end the game with this cap on this defensive flag for White Fox. They're looking to close it out with a cap.
Yep, that is Jap's Eye Squad back at it again with the behind the flank maneuvers there, getting behind these White Fox guys.
Good job, boys.
Nice, and then they Japs. Go neutral on that field.
If you can stay there for that.
Comes, sorry.
9 tickets left here for White Fox.
Japs, I'm sending 3 or 4 of my guys to you.
Oh, good, mate. Oh, good. Nice and quiet here at the moment.
Roger.
Yeah, we've got quite a few still north of the D. Up the gully, north of the D, on the marker.
Half cap now.
Down to the final few tickets here for White Fox.
Yeah, they might be able to win here off this flag cap.
We're going
to
push off quickly and cap their last if you can move forward.
Redcoat's still talking about capturing that last flag. I don't think they have any idea how low the White Fox guys are on their tickets.
Japs, tell you what. Start sending a couple of your guys now if you want. There should be enough of us there to cap
it.
Yeah,
we're 80%. 80% now.
80% on the cap, and Redcoats are doing the typical Redcoats move. They're already going to start moving some guys off onto that next flag there. Already talking about it.
Starting to see a couple of the Redcoats now get broken up as White Fox really are coming in now from the eastern side, and we've just got a couple of individuals spread across.
Oh.
Oops.
Well in, boys. Well.
Great job.
Get in there, boys. Well done.
Yeah.
Well done, boys.
Very strong showing there for the Redcoats as they take White Fox and move on.
Great job.
In our tournament here.
Well done, team. Well fucking done. Good game.
Very good game there for White Fox, though. Hanging on in there. Redcoats are able to squeak out these two victories. Now, we have one more match for the day. We've got Ghost versus HSG Elite coming up. That is going to be on Logar, so those tight streets of Logar. That is going to be very interesting. So that's coming up in just about 20 minutes here. We are going to go to a short intermission, and then we're going to talk a little bit about tactics and throw some of these maps back up on screen before we get started. So we are looking at about 25 minutes until that next match coming up.